If you go to India, you want to eat biryani, it must be Hyderabad. That's the specialty. Hi, I'm Govind. I'm 50 and I'm cooking a hot thing, Hyderabad Dum Biryani. My shop is Mr Biryani. I'm cooking last 12 years and actually cooking is like a part of my life. I was 18 years in this F&B industry. I used to work as a banquet operation director. I left because I want to start my own business. South India have about 5 states. Hyderabad is one of the cities in the one of the South Indian states. Hyderabad is an early settlement by the Yemenis Muslims. If you talk about Hyderabad, it's about biryani. It's like a very traditional way of Muslims in Hyderabad make biryani. So more or less, they still keep the tradition of making the biryani very authentic. So that's the unique part of the Hyderabad Dum Biryani. To make a good biryani, you need a very good spices. Green cardamom, a special ingredient called a nutmeg flour, a sar jeera, ginger garlic paste, the coriander leaf from India. So here are all my selected spices. While boiling this, we'll start marinating the chicken. Right? To marinate the meat, the first process will be adding the ginger and garlic paste. Sar jeera, not many people use for biryani cooking. These flavors make different compared to the rest of the biryani. There's some fresh coriander leaf and mint leaf. Roasted anise is the main key ingredient for the taste of the biryani. Because we already removed the fat, so we need to add oil. Special chili powder come from Andhra Pradesh. They call Guntur chili powder. This is our own garam masala that we blended ourselves. Home blended coriander powder. A bit of cumin powder. This is called a methi leaf. So it's a dry leaf of fenugreek. Turmeric is always a part of Indian cooking. So we use a homemade yogurt. So I'm going to stir it again to make the marination evenly done. We're going to rest it for a while before we start.
The difference between Hyderabad Dum Biryani and the normal biryani is the cooking technique and the ingredient they use and the flavor and the texture is totally different compared to the more North Indian or the extreme South India like Tamil Nadu. The Hyderabad chicken dum biryani, they marinate the raw chicken, they rest it, then they boil the ingredients in the water, then they strain out, then they parboil the rice, then they place the rice on top of the raw meat, then they seal the pot. That's called dum biryani in Hyderabad. South Indian, like Tamil Nadu, what they do, they will fry everything in the oil, spices and the meat, everything once cooked, then they pour the water, then they put the rice, they cook it together. That's what for them, they call it a dum biryani. So you'll see the texture will be different, like can be more soft or soggy. And Hyderabad dum biryani generally is like a little bit more to dry and less oil. Singapore biryani, nasi biryani, right? If you ask me, they don't call it biryani in India. They call it like a pulao rice or they call it like a bagari rice in Andhra Pradesh. What we get in Singapore is an authentic Singapore style biryani. But where else I'm doing an authentic Hyderabad dum biryani. So everyone make their biryani according to the ingredients and the facilities they have in their location. The Kashmiri called Kashmiri style biryani. Then the South Indian, they have a short grain rice. They call it Jeera Sambar rice biryani. And obviously Hyderabad, they call Hyderabad dum biryani according to the location. Some people ask, is it authentic Hyderabad dum biryani? I said, if you ask me, everything is the factor. Water, meat, ingredient. So on my side, I try to get at least fresh, dry ingredient like herbs and the fresh ingredient like a coriander leaf, mint leaf, green chili, the ginger. Right. So if you ask me, our biryani is very close to Hyderabad Dum Biryani. I chose to make Hyderabad Dum Biryani because number one, I love the cooking technique and I love the ingredient that they use, very fresh. And I love the flavor of the biryani itself. Each year, I go back my kampong, right, for like Deepavali and all that. So I'll preparing the biryani for my whole family. We are a big family, around 50 of us. My mom have 29 grandchildren. It's very fun to cook together with the family. Even my motto is like sharing and caring. Life is better when we dine together.